This is Porky's on Atari 2600, based on the comedy film from the early 80s. It was one of the early examples of naughty comedies geared towards adults, and belongs in the same family of movies like Animal House and Caddyshack. Although not as classic and memorable as those, it has its place, and all of today's dumb comedies owe themselves to it. And likewise, all today's weird, twisted, fucked up, shitty-ass video games owe themselves to this! You wanna play shit? This is your grandfather's shit. What happened? Only on Atari. It's never a good sign when you don't know how to play the game. I've fallen into a trap. The walls are dead ends, and the water is pure death. To get out of this predicament, you have to use this pole to fling yourself up onto the platforms. But that's not all. You need to collect these blinking things to build the ladders. Fuck! Fuck! Get up there! For a game console that has only one button, the controls are very specific. While holding the button down, you run into the pole and then quickly release the button and tap it. If that tap is off in the slightest, you'll just swing to the other side of the pond. But if you do it at the exact microsecond, it will fling you up onto the platform. Alright, now let's build the ladder. It only adds one link at a time. So you have to wait for another blinky thing to appear and keep repeating the whole process until the ladders are finished. There's no way around it. You have to master this pole. This isn't even the goal of the game. This is just to get out of the trap. Now up the ladder and there's a girl taking a shower. There is a scene in the movie where the guys are spying on the locker room shower, but I did not expect them to include this scene in the game. Why is she showering in a room full of ladders anyway? The shower itself is suspended in midair. As soon as she's in your field of sight, she disappears and a ghostly figure starts chasing you. Get away! I'm sorry, I'm not a sleazy sexual predator, I'm just a guy trying to escape the pond that's underneath your shower room. These are some of the most awkward ladders in video game history. In most games, you go in front of the ladder, but here, you have to be on the side, and if you're not in the pixel-perfect spot, it doesn't work. So this strange woman is chasing you everywhere. She glides through the air with such power that it causes the game to glitch, as if sending a ripple through space and time. What do I do with this thing? I tried dropping it on her head. Doesn't work. Tried going up. Doesn't work. I tried going down. Really doesn't work. And if she catches you, it's back to the pond. Believe it or not, this whole predicament in the locker room closely follows the movie. The woman who's after you is the coach, Miss Ballbreaker, who finds one of the boys putting his dick through a peephole in the shower. You'd think a scene like this would get ignored in a video game, but this is Atari, and sure enough, the manual says she's out to grab onto anything she can, so don't let her latch onto you. Yeah. The character you're playing as is Pee-wee, not Pee-wee Herman, but Pee-wee from Porky's, which doesn't make sense anyway because Pee-wee's not the character who gets his dick grabbed, not Pee-wee Herman, he can grab his own dick, but what are we talking about here? I'll cut the shit. Here's what you do. Drop the items down the hole, the arrow appears, you go up the ladder to street level where you play some sort of game of Frogger, on acid. What the hell are these things? If you get hit by anything, it's, you guessed it, back to the pond. If you make it across the street, it's another round of Shower Girl Defender Ms. Ballbreaker. Each time it's a new item, but the process is exactly the same. All these items are part of a master plan to blow up Porky's bar. I didn't think it had a rhyme or a reason, but it does. It just so happens you have to trek through a woman's locker room, that's all. After you've gotten all the items, you progress to the worst part, the mother of all nightmares. Here you have to climb up the scaffolding while avoiding Porky. Yeah, now we have Porky too. Not Porky the pig, but Porky from Porky's. The scaffolding can only be climbed in certain places. It's basically like an invisible maze. One wrong move and you could fall all the way down where Porky will most certainly get you almost every time. When you make it back to try again, the maze reroutes itself so it's always different. But as your reward, when you make it to the top, you get to blow up the bar. What an experience Pee-wee had. Can you imagine the story he has to tell? I was walking down the street, narrowly avoiding a speedboat, a submarine on wheels, a parade of naked Dr. Seuss characters, rabid pigs, dudes in cars. I fell down into a pond where I swung around on a pole and built a ladder up into a girl's locker room shower where this weird blobby ghost tried to grab my dick. I dropped a bunch of pyro equipment down the same hole that leads to the pond, but somehow ended up on top of a bunch of scaffolding where I went up and finished it all off with a BOOM! And that's why you gotta love Atari.